Texting and driving is a bad habit and illegal, but many people just can't seem to stop. Now a number of apps are on the market to step in and take that temptation away. But how does it work? News 8's Aly Myles takes a closer look. Aly.
Yeah, Tracy, it's no secret that texting and driving is dangerous. Some people believe it's just as bad as drinking and driving, and that's where apps like these come in handy. You can download apps nowadays that basically paralyze your phone, that stop you from being able to read your text messages. There's apps that reward you if you use them and you don't use your phone in the car. And there's also apps like these that will read your messages and emails out loud to you. Some Mainers believe it's apps like these that can save lives.
Kind of disappointing.
It's a problem Rocco Navarro says he sees all the time.
And it's pretty cut and dry because you pull up to a row of cars, you look in the window, you know, you see people going like this, you know they're not making a call.
The South Portland police officer says even though there are laws to stop folks from distracted driving, the statistics show they haven't.
You know, I don't think our accidents have gone down at all. I would hope one day we drift towards totally hands-free like a lot of the other states are doing. I think that would have more of an impact.
And Navarro is part of the reason Maine has anti-texting and driving laws at all.
And I don't really remember too much because I totally got knocked out and my head snapped back and knocked this pad into this glass here. And I just remember waking up in the hospital.
2 years ago, Navarro was helping with a broken down car on the Casco Bay Bridge. That's when he says a man who was texting and driving slammed into the back of his cruiser.
Looking back, my road to recovery, it's just kind of surreal knowing that it was a text message that did that to me.
Technology is not going to go away.
Highway Safety Director Lauren Stewart says it's happened to more than just Rocco Navarro. Road-related deaths in Maine went up after the laws went into effect, but they were lower in 2012 than the 10-year average.
My question is, do we need that constant contact, or can you turn that phone off and put it away for 5 minutes while you're driving, or the time it takes you to pull over? Very few of those text messages are actually an emergency. They can wait.
And that's why some companies have created apps to stop people from even being able to text behind the wheel. Some of the popular ones are Drive Alive, Safe Cell app, and I'm Addicted.
When I turn on my phone, I have it set so the feature would come on.
I'm going to try calling you.
Drive Mode is an app offered by AT&T that stops your phone from receiving texts, calls, or emails when you're on the road. When someone tries to contact you, the app sends them a text saying you'll respond when you're not behind the wheel.
This is the standard. Thanks for your message. I'm driving and unable to reply. I will get back to you soon. When it comes to texting and driving, it can wait. Either way, it's free.
Users can set the app to cut off incoming communication when stopped for at least 5 minutes.
Just let it go. Did you get a text?
Just got our text.
And really the message is that no text is worth dying for. And when it comes to texting and driving, it can wait.
A message Navarro says he fully understands.
I'm fortunate to even be here, so I never take that for granted.
Now, like I said, there are multiple apps you can download in both Android and iTunes to get onto your phone. For a complete list of those, go to our website, WMTW.com. Reporting live in the car in Portland, Aly Myles, News 8.